Good afternoon. I welcome you all to Afan University's fourth EdTech Lounge. COVID-19 has disrupted on-campus teaching and learning, and faculty members at Afan University have either already started teaching or they are planning to teach online courses very soon. EdTech Lounge is a virtual space for faculty members to have conversations about online and remote teaching and learning in the challenging context. And for the next 2 months, EdTech Lounge sessions will be held every Wednesday at the same time. Our today's speaker is Dr. Sadia Fatma, who is an assistant professor and chair of MBBS Year 2 Curriculum Subcommittee at the Department of Biological and Biomedical Sciences, Afan University. Dr. Sadia has been involved in teaching and learning and research activities at Afan University since 2012. Across various undergraduate and postgraduate modules. Sadia has received 2 Scholarship of Teaching and Learning grants for medical education projects. She has published and presented at international venues. Dr. Sadia is a trained facilitator for teaching, learning, and enhancement workshop, and is a recipient of Outstanding Teachers Merit Award. She is currently pursuing Foundation for Advancement of International Medical Education and Research, FAMER Fellowship from Philadelphia, USA.
Okay, thank you. Assalamu alaikum and good afternoon. What I'm going to do today is share my experience with you and some of the roadmap that we took to deliver an online curriculum for the UGME years 1 and 2. So an SOS call was generated across the globe for COVID-19 crisis management. On March 13th, medical students were informed that they should go home and stay safe, and all the academic activities at AKU will no longer continue. A Herculean task was then given to the UGME years 1 and 2 chair to convert the teaching learning activities to tele-teaching by March 19th. So the strategy that we adapted helped us not only to plan, train, execute, and fine-tune the content to fit online teaching, but also provided us with a challenge that today I am proud to report that our faculty, students, and staff fulfilled with flying colors. The who and why of our strategy were pretty straightforward. We then deliberated on the why aspect. Give them the summer break right now and continue with regular classes later on. But then in the end, we decided to proceed with the online teaching, thinking about the loss of our learners' knowledge and time in these uncertain situations. The next concern we had was where. Since the university was closed, where will the faculty be conducting their sessions from? What about distractions, noise? What about electricity breakdown, internet connectivity? Where would our students be? Will they be in Pakistan or they will go abroad? What about the time zone differences? So all of these things had to be considered beforehand. Once we planned multiple strategies to minimize all of these issues, we moved on to the biggest quest, which was what? We had to identify need to know versus nice to know for the online teaching. Realign the module objective, the learning outcome, session timing, mode of teaching, all to fit an online strategy. We wanted an engaging, interactive, active learning environment to promote deeper learning in our students. So most of our time was actually spent on designing pop quiz, assignments, flipped classrooms, pre-reading and pre-recording viewing materials to be made available for the students. We were concerned about diverse learning styles as well, so we tried to make all of these as multimodal as possible. The biggest hit for us was actually the platform choice. We were all familiar with Zoom, and we thought that this is the one that we are going to use. But very quickly we realized the limitations, that we had a very limited number of licenses, and therefore we were unable to use Zoom for 10 different classes teaching at the same time. Now what? So So the IT department came to our rescue and shared with us another platform called Microsoft Teams. But we did not know about it. We had never tested it. We did not know the functionality, the requirements. So a select group, including myself, piloted and explored its functionality. With some reservations, we opted to use that platform. I then proceeded in developing basic tutorial videos ranging from how to install to delivery, how to install to delivering the LCF, PBL tutorials, how to record the sessions and then share them with the students. These training tutorials were in addition to the numerous training sessions planned by the UGME office and conducted by us for faculty, staff and students. The last piece of our puzzle was the how. We opted for both synchronous and asynchronous teaching methods. We developed an SOP for assistance. WhatsApp groups, Microsoft Teams support groups were created with designated people available during office hours. Well, if I'm very frank with you, over and beyond office hours as well, technically 24/7. This provided support in real time. We devised formative assessments to keep our students active and motivated and keep them up to date with their academic proceedings. Parents were kept in the loop. They were sent the revised schedules and they were told about the formative assessments as well. All of this led us to develop or complete the loop. We also added reflections from the students and from the faculty in order to fine tweak whatever we were designing. So in the beginning, this is how we felt, puzzled, unsure, but once the plan was strategized, this is how the UGME team felt. And we were confident that something good is going to happen out of this exercise. Here's a screenshot that shows you the tutorial videos that were shared with the faculty members. These were supplementary materials, and in addition to the videos, we also developed a written instruction because some people, especially me, if I talk about myself, I like to read the instructions first and then watch and then do it later on. So keeping that in mind, we had to develop a written feedback or a written instruction manual as well. You can see by the number of views that almost 300 participants or more than that were trained during a very short span of time. So, reflections and modifications are the key elements for a successful intervention. As I've told you before, that we were constantly in contact with our students who were our end users, and I'm sharing with you some reflections that we received in the initial stages of our online curriculum. The students were happy with what we did. They liked and appreciated the online teaching. We saw an improved attendance. The lecture recordings and assessments that we gave the students helped them improve their learning. One of the first year students even wrote a blog about it and appreciated the intervention. So now what? Once everything goes back to normal, should we just leave everything behind and continue with our usual way? Or should we learn something out of this intervention and continue doing all of those when we return back to the face-to-face component? I propose for the later. So here are some key lessons which we learned during our exercise. What we learned was that everyone is capable to use technology. It's just a change of mindset. And COVID-19 helped us sort of reach the change of mindset. The change was good in this case. Even senior faculty members were enthusiastic in learning how to use Microsoft Teams, how to record their lectures, how to add in quizzes, and they wanted to do it themselves. This was something which was very encouraging. We realized that not everything could be taught online, such as PBLs and clinical skills. They're better done face-to-face. Therefore, a blended learning approach should be the future. We were able to identify redundant sessions in the curriculum, so we should remove them in the future. Not only that, but also we identified alternate teaching modalities for some of the sessions. And I think these alternate methods served a better mode as compared to the ones which we were using beforehand. So we should continue with the other option. The interesting thing was that the BOPS lesson plan was religiously submitted for peer review by majority of the faculty members. This is something which should continue when we return back to the face-to-face mode of teaching. Quiz, chat, flipped classrooms, formative assessments, in my opinion, should continue. One piece of advice is that as a lead, you should stay connected and monitor what is happening, but please avoid micromanaging. Lecture recordings and learning resources should be shared with both the faculty and the students, and that should be continued. The biggest thing which we observed was the teamwork. So the engagement between students, faculty, and admin staff was admirable. And that is the major, major, major reason for the success of this intervention. And I think that this should continue. Another food for thought, which when I was going through the recorded lectures came to me, was that since we have all the recorded sessions available, we can maybe use them for teaching squares or for informal peer review to help ourselves in order to improve the way we teach. And maybe by improving our way of teaching, we can improve the way the students learn and make them more competent and make them learn better. In the end, a huge shout out to the core team whose efforts, commitment, dedication, enthusiasm, support, and guidance made it all possible. Teamwork is the key to having a successful intervention. And I do not have enough superlatives to actually tell you how teamwork worked in this situation. So on a lighter note, I just came across this Dr. Su's take on digital learning while I was looking for online teaching. I wanted to share this with you. This was published in Teachers Mag for students in the kindergarten. So it goes like this. I will teach you in a room. I will teach you now on Zoom. I will teach you in your house. I will teach you with a mouse. I will teach you because I care. So just do your very best and do not worry about the rest. So I think this is what all of us as teachers are trying to do in order to enhance our students' learning and avoid their losses. So stay home, stay safe, and never stop learning. Thank you very much.